Oops. Didn't mean to do that. Oh.
What rubbish! What balderdash!
You must have read something terribly disturbing, Watson, for you to be so overwrought this early in the morning.
Indeed, Holmes. It's irresponsible of the Times to play upon people's superstitions.
Ah, you must be referring to the affair of the Mummy's Curse.
The entire city in an uproar. Three men dead, and they expect us to believe that a 4,000-year-old mummy was the murderer. I'm surprised you haven't taken some interest in this case, Holmes.
To the contrary, my dear Watson. I have made some inquiries, because I dare say I do believe this murderer is a much younger chap.
All right, so not the top button.
What did you learn, Watson?
Not a thing, Holmes.
You learned nothing?
Don't get testy, Holmes. There wasn't anyone about.
My humble apologies, Watson.
All right. It's a lot easier when I have the newspaper and all the other stuff that goes with this game out. But you get the idea. Our notes are... Let me go ahead and see if we can call this person.
It's quite amusing, all this hoopla over a mummy's curse, I must say. Not so amusing, of course, the murder of three Englishmen.
Have any of your reporters uncovered anything new?
Actually, I've been in Paris the past several weeks. Just returned to London on Tuesday. I've had no involvement with the writing of any of these articles. I believe they are all the work of Philip Travis. He's one of our young reporters. For a short time, he was the Egyptian correspondent.
Was he sacked?
No. He returned to London just a few days ago. I gather he was reassigned to cover the case from here because he had some familiarity with the murder in Egypt.
Do you know Travis?
No. Never actually met the chap, although I hear he's a bit of an odd duck.
Thanks for your help, Henry.
Anytime. Let me know when you catch the mummy. That's one scoop I'd like to get.
All right. Notepad, Travis. I can't talk to Travis. It's weird. All right, you know, I think you get the gist of this one.